Hi folks, and good afternoon and welcome. Let's just change to the other camera and let's have a play. Right, let's go to the other monitor. Go to that. Do that. Do that. And to that. Right. There we've got one watching. Is that just me or has somebody else popped in? Good afternoon to you all, or good evening even. Right. Right, what I'm going to do today. Just get me a remote control. I won't be able to see. Oh yeah, I'll be able to see the chat on this phone. We've got it, I'm holding it today. Or most of it. Hello, Scraps. Right. Just. That ain't it. Go on. Oi. I'll give you a bath. Yeah. He's been quiet all day. The minute I decided to come live, he fucking mivers. So I'll tell him he's getting a bath, he soon runs off. Right. This is the Acorn Electron, which I purchased the other day. And just moved my phone. Put that there for now. I purchased this the other day from a friend of mine called Mick. And I gave him, I already told you. Gave him £40, but I also got that realistic scanner that's up there as well, which has already been repaired. There's a video on that. I think there is, if I've not lost the footage. If I have, it's tough. I'm not repairing it twice. Right. Right, well, so far with this, I've ordered a shift key for there, because obviously I nicked the shift key to put so I could have the E key. The 5 needs doing and the return needs doing. They work most of the time, but sometimes they don't, so I've got some keys on their way. I've got the joystick to service. I've got the joystick module plugged in the back. That's a first bite module. Not all the games that support it, but the ones that do ask you if you've got it, and if you have, then it'll allow you. Right, well, what I'm going to do, I'm not going to put a game in that I already know works. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to put a game in I already know works. I'm going to put a game in that I haven't even tested yet. Oh, fucking hell. Jesus. Good evening, Mark. And I hope you're... Hope you're in fine feckle. I like looking under the boxes in these, under the plastic bits, because you never know what you find. I mean, I've never found anything interesting under one yet, but you never know, do you? Someone could have stashed some old money in there at some time, but I've not been that lucky. Right, for the Acorn Electron. For the Acorn Electron, no matter which way you put it in. So what we'll do, we'll put that. This is that tape recorder I've repaired and serviced, and it works very well. Let's turn the Acorn on. There we go. The Electron's version of BBC Basic. So what we need to do is type in chain, otherwise we can't get the motor, and I want to rewind the tape. I can't be asked unplugging it from the side, so I'll just type in. And two of them. And... So, I mean, there we are, we're at the beginning. There we go. That little bit at the bottom there, a little white thing at the bottom, is me mute, because the television's on mute. It doesn't need to be, what do you call it, anyway, because we're, the sound comes out of the Acorn anyway. Doesn't come out of the telly. But as you can see, it appears to be loading. And I'll give you a quick look at the computer while it does that. As you can see, it's fairly clean, this Acorn. It's not bad. I mean, there we are. Acorn Soft. Like their name, didn't they? You know, instead of giving you a nice bright colour picture, they just plastered Acorn Soft all down the screen, and it tells you the name of it right in the middle there, which is Maze. Let's move up a bit closer to the screen. I don't know whether I've picked the right game to demonstrate this, because, you know, we want something with some colour in, don't we? And I don't know whether this game's going to do it for us. But but we'll find out. Where's my, what do you call it? Because I can put some sort of news bulletin coming through. I can put this. Put this on the helping hands, because I'm not, and it says it's shaking everywhere. There we go. There we go. Turn that round. Lift it up. That's loose, that, and I can't find. Can't find anything to tighten that to just nip it with. There's a pair of pliers, that might do it. Just want to nip this nut here. That's got it. There we go. Let's drop them pliers down there. Right. Move my shit. Right. That'll do. That wire dangling, there we go. Hey, they really do love their name, don't they? Right. Turn left. Da 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 da. Joystick, keys. It might not work with the joystick. The joystick needs a service, but we'll rest that there. There we go. Sorry about that wire dangling down. Not really a lot I can do about it. No, it won't work with that joystick. Not because I haven't got the cassette to put the drivers in. But it will work it will work with games that do support it. So it's Z, C, X and F. I'll never remember that. I didn't even touch that. That got into some sort of demo mode. Right, the keys are sensitive. F. What the fuck's that? That's the way I came in, isn't it? Is that the way I came in? I ain't got a fucking clue. Let's review the maze. So obviously I'm there, I'm that arrow. So I press V. Yeah, I need to go the other way, don't I? I need to go the other way. You know what I should do? I should write. I should write the fucking numbers down. See, I'm still no further fucking forward. Because I can't fucking understand. Yeah, anyway, that's... Yeah, I can't fucking remember what they were. Right, well, let's kill that anyway. Right. Just type in chain to rewind the tape, sort of turn the motor back on. So I can rewind the tape. I don't need to, do I? Because it's the same on the other side, so... Just pop it in the other side next time I use it. If I ever use it. Try another one, see if we find someone with a bit of action in it. But that's not... Not the, what's this one here? Let's try this one, Boxer. That looks fairly exciting. Try that one. If it's in here. It is. Well, there's a cassette in there. It does appear to say Boxer on it. Looks a bit worse for wear though. Don't think that's going to work, to be honest. I don't think that's going to work. Let's put my glasses on. Looks a bit shit. Looks a bit fucked, that tape. Let's get me tape binder. Where's my fucking glasses? My frigging glasses gone. What I'm going to do, I'm going to put it in that way. Hey, Christine.
Hi,
you alright?
What?
Yeah, I'm just doing a live video. You do me a cup of coffee if you will. But there's my glasses, I've just found them. Right. So.
Okay.
No, not yet, it's not time yet. We'll rewind that. Fuck have you just trod on then?
No.
You trod on something and it went crunch. Well, give them a beer. Here's.
My cup.
Yeah, I know.
Got you on,
Andy. Yeah, I have. I put my gas on before. Don't put your fingers inside my cup. Well, I know, you could have been scratching your bum. Anyway, right, so let's see if this side of the tape plays. I know the other one won't. Because you could see through the tape. I I mean, not all of them are like that. I mean, most of what I've tried have actually worked. I think there's only one that didn't. Well, it's identifying it anyway, so we might be lucky. This cassette recorder's not bad, it's actually quite a good one. That's looking interesting. Yeah, I know, I'll have a word with Mildred, ask her to pick me some bits up in a bit. Yeah. Right, so we're loading. Whether it gets to the end is another, whether it completes the process is another matter. What I want to know, if anybody knows, I don't know whether anybody does, but if anybody knows where you can actually get audio files, where you can get these in audio files so you can put them on to cassette yourself. I mean, there's plenty of ROMs, but I don't know how you convert a ROM into an audio file or whether you can even do that. But it'd be nice to get the audio files, and then I could just put the games either on my phone or on a cassette, and do it that way. So if anybody knows, then be fruitful with the information and let me know. But that's not too bad, that. Considering it's on, it's an old computer on a modern television. And that's going through the RF as well, by the way, folks. And I'll tell you now, the RF output is not as bad as everybody says it is. You know, it really isn't. I mean, back in the day it was what we had. We had the RF output, and we didn't have much of anything else. So, you know, in my opinion, it's acceptable, and I can live with that without a problem. I see somebody's popped in the chat. I don't know who it was. By the time I got my glasses on, they'd gone. Here we go. Hello, Harvey. Yeah, we've got four people in, four people liking it. Lovely. This is what we like to see. Yeah, it's not bad for its age. I mean, when all said and done. I know these Acorn Elks did have their problems, like the ULA, for example. The ULA has an habit of dying in them. You know, I'm going to order some heat sinks for this one. I've not done a recap. Why? Because the voltages are okay. So I don't find it necessary to mess about putting capacitors in. I can mess with a computer that works. There we are. I've gone to searching now, so that's where the fault is in the tape. That'll play up in a minute. There we are. Got a feeling this won't load because of that fault in the tape. But that's no problem, because I will find another copy of it, and but I don't think the other side will load. I don't think it'll get this far. But I think we've got to the end of that, and the tape has stopped. Yeah, the tape has actually stopped. So has it eaten it, or No, it's got to the end, but it hasn't loaded the game because of the problem. So what we'll do, we'll try this side. And try this side. You never know, it might, the damage bit might be before it starts to bleep. If it comes up with the other side of the tape was okay at the beginning, so if it comes up, if it identifies the name, there's every chance that this might even load. You never know. We'll see. But yeah, these tapes are all, they're all 40 odd years old. They are. They're all 40 odd years old. You know, being 40 odd years old, they've got every right to not work. I mean, come on. You know, they're over 40 years old. But yeah, that might actually load. The other side didn't. The program must have gone on right to the end of the tape. And where you could see through the tape, there must have been some information there that it needed. I can remember doing this on the Commodore VIC-20 and the Commodore 64 and the Plus 4. But this is the first Acorn I've ever had. I've had a couple of BBC Micros. I've had a couple of those. But this is basically the cut down version of the Micro, but very cut down because it can't do anywhere near, from what I believe, it can't do anywhere near what the Micro can do. It is pretty severely handicapped, I believe. Limited in what it can do. But we'll see what we get here. See if it actually loads the game. If it does, then that's fair enough. But what we don't want to see is that loading change to searching. Because if it does, then we know it's not going to load. I've got a stack of games there. How many games have I got there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, hang on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And the welcome cassette, class that is 11. The welcome cassette got severely eaten up by this tape recorder. Hence the reason why I serviced the tape recorder last night. Because the welcome cassette got eaten up by it. But luckily, the only part of the welcome cassette that got damaged was the introduction. The rest of the cassette works. So, you know, I was lucky there. On all side B of the cassette works. Just the introduction bit on side one that doesn't. But the rest of it does. You just type in the program by name that you want. Once it's loaded that one, it'll ask you if you want to go to the next one automatically. It's still usable. But something you only use once, isn't it, the introductory cassette. You look at it once to see what's on it, find there's nothing worth really having. And you move on to something else. I hope this game works actually, because it looks pretty interesting. But yeah, there we go. Yeah, it does work. Press space bar or fire. I know the joystick won't work, but we'll try it anyway. No, 1984 this game was made. Use S and Q to turn the sound on and off. Well, we want the sound on, so we'll leave it as is. We'll just, we won't bother looking at the controls. We'll just hit the space bar and see what the game... Yeah, so... But basically, what you're doing, you're... And you can hit Harry Carry. Ooh. Ooh. And you get wiped out. Yeah. And you end up dropping down. And again. I didn't look at the controls, did I? So on again. I didn't look at the controls, did I? Well, that's it. It works. I mean, what more can I say? It works. We'll rewind this one. Rewind. Just tell it to search while it rewinds. But that's it. I mean, that tape actually works. There we go. So we'll put that in the box. Put that there. Put it up there with the other stuff. I mean, I got the operation manual. I'm keen to see what this one does. What this one is, Sphinx Adventure. I'm keen to see what this one is, because I don't know. All I know, it just says that on it, so we'll see. But I don't even know if it fucking plays. But we'll soon find out. Rewind the tape. Play. At least it doesn't time out, and so, you know, it'll stay searching there. Probably for as long as you want it to. At least it doesn't time out, so you can actually just type in the command and hit the enter key and see it turns the motor back on. Because the cassette recorder's got motor control. Which is good because it just stops the tape for you. And which is good when you've got a tape with multiple programs on it. It'll do it for you. You know, so you don't accidentally go past. It knows when to stop it. Well, it's loading it so far. And this is the last game to check out, really. The ones that are on the top of the cassette recorder, they've been checked. And, yeah, so I didn't count it. So like 12 games or something, 30... Pretty well about 14 games, 15 games or something that actually work. I think there was two out of the whole lot that didn't work. Do you want a biscuit, Christine?
Yeah.
I thought you might.
Yeah,
hang on a minute. Hey, I've got a full one.
Stop moaning.
How about that, folks? You've done me a full one.
Stop.
Normally only get half a one.
You got a full one this morning as well.
Yeah. You know what she did this morning? Rang me up at fucking 7 o'clock. Fucking 7 o'clock she rang me up. Are you putting the kettle on, was it? What was it you said?
I was putting the kettle on.
Yeah, I said, go back to sleep, it's 7 o'clock.
Oh, Laura was getting up at 7 o'clock.
Fucking 7 o'clock! Still the middle of the night for me, that Christine. Yeah, I know, but fucking hell, just because you were going to Tesco doesn't mean to say you had to get me up at 7 o'clock. Hey, you were lucky you never got screamed at.
I was up already.
No, I was in bed, but I was knackered. Yeah, scraps. There you go. How many do you want?
Four.
Yeah, well, you better have five.
No,
I'll have one after. I'm not. I can't sit here munching biscuits. Anyway, Scraps has had one. You've had five. I'll nip it. I'll nab a couple later. I'll have a couple of them in a bit. I'll just have my coffee because I had something to eat earlier. What? Yeah, I know it is. You don't need to tell me. Right. My hip's still bad as well. Hey? Yeah. Yeah, mate. Yeah. Oh, you won't get a sore arm tomorrow. You get it in a few days. You don't get a sore arm straight away, I don't think. Me fucking... I got down on the floor to put the gas card in. Me bloody hip went, I couldn't get back up. Yeah, I couldn't get out. I was in agony getting back up. I'm all right once I'm up and I'm sat down. If I have to get the crouch right down like that, I can't do it. And if I have to walk a distance, I can't do it either. I'm getting old, folks. I'm getting old and decrepit. You know, I'm not as young as I used to be. And you'd have thought Acorn would have put some colour in the title, wouldn't you? You know. Hey, 6 out of 6. Oh, 7 people watching and 6 people like. Yeah, obviously. Obviously, you like vintage computers. Yeah, well, we're getting near the end of the tape, so let's hope we're going to load. I think we are, because it would have come up with an error by now. Well, it come up with an error if it gets to an error on the tape, won't it? But, yeah. I like these. I like adventure games. Go north, go south, go to get to fuck, and yeah. I've got a Dr. Soft game here, which is 747, but it won't work on here because it needs the plus one pack, the plus one accessory that screws to the back, and I haven't got it, so I can't play that one, which is a bit of a shame. Because it obviously requires, yeah. Oh, it's not going to just give me writing, is it? It's going to give me a picture. You are on the top of a mountain. In the distance is a small building. A small building can be seen. A road leads north. There are exits north and south, east and west. I'm going to go north and see where it takes me. North. So, can you pick up the bottle? I don't know, I'll have to read the instructions. You are on the road, a small raised path leads east. Yeah, da 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 da. It looks nothing like it does on the picture, does it? I thought it would have been some sort of graphical interface. It's not really, is it? Yeah, so get bottle. Probably want to know what to do. You got the bottle. Yay. Right. Now we want to go north again. You are at the end of the road by a building. There are exits north, south. Let's go south. Probably go back the way I fucking came, knowing my luck. Yeah. Yeah, back where I was. Let's go west. The village people didn't they? No. See, the return key had no effect then. You are in the forest. Well, got there quick. You are in the forest. There are exits. North, south, east and west. Let's go east. It's got all over the place. You are in the forest. There are exits here. Let's keep going east. It's just got a good set there. Eh? Where? Wonder if I hit the question mark. Let's go west. Let's go east. You are at the end of a road by a building that is, yeah. I think you could get pretty bored of that very quickly, couldn't you? You've got to sit and work out where you're going. I'm just pressing buttons, not really giving a shit, so. Rewind the tape. On some of these games, it tells you to type in CH and two of those comma things, two of those quotation mark things. But when you do that, they don't bloody work. So you have to type, I just type in chain for every command. I think it must have been, for every time, it must have been an error or something. Just type in chain every time and it'll load your game up. And that's it. What I want a copy of, Arcadians. Not Arcadians, what's it called? I'll tell you in a minute. Is it Arkanoids? Because I've got Arkanoids here, but it's badly damaged. Is it Arkanoids or Arcadians? I can't fucking put my glasses on. Arcadians, I thought it was. Yeah, if I try and load this, it won't have it. Let's try it anyway. Because it's damaged. It might actually now. But we'll try it, but I don't think it will. I think it comes up. On this side, it comes up with a load of mush. As the title. I'm sure it does. But it'd be nice to get a copy of this because the game looks good. So. There's another, like the other one, there's a bad piece at the beginning and it just won't identify it. What's that on the chat there? Can I get to it before it fades away? No, it disappeared. Right. I'll keep my glasses on for a minute and watch the chat for someone popping up. Yeah. It was seven. Oh, someone's just dropped off. There was seven there a minute ago. Yeah, that's not going to. Yeah, that's not going to load, is it? That's not going to load. That would have started by now. So what we'll do. I mean, that looks okay, but it is damaged. Let's rewind that and we'll type in the command again. Just reset it. Might as well shouldn't have to reset it because it didn't take anything in, so. But I'll reset it anyway. It identifies it but won't load. I think he gets near the end, if I remember rightly. Because that's where the damage is at the end of the tape.
Miranda.
Yeah, see you tomorrow, Christine. Yeah. Ah, that's just the one where it won't fucking... You know what I mean? Yeah, that's the problem it's got. It's, won't load. It won't load it, so... That's what it does. The tape is damaged, but it's damaged in a place where you need it to not be damaged. So that looks okay, but it's damaged, obviously, because that tape was actually stuck. It wouldn't move when I got it. What have we got left here? We've already had these in. We've had that in and that plays. One of these doesn't. I think it's this one, the last ninja. Yeah, that plays. You'd find a case for it, you see. There's a kung fu one that wouldn't play. I don't know where it's gone. But there was a kung fu one. Let's try that kung fu one again. Not that I want to play kung fu, I don't. But this one wouldn't play, and it's in a case, and it looks perfectly and everything. It doesn't damage that out. Right. But it won't play. Rewind it. Yeah, I'm keeping an eye on the chat where I can. If I spot it, I'll put the main screen back on in a minute and have a look. We'll just make this the last one. There we go. I'm not doing what everyone else does, typing in 10, printing my fucking name, and 20 go to 10, and then hitting run, typing run, and I'm not doing that, because every fucker does that. A five-year-old child knows how to do that. I'd rather just load a few games up. So, I mean, it clicks there and it's gone to searching again. But we'll see what it does, because it did that. See if it actually this time it's come up loading. Imagine it did that before and all. But we'll see what it does this time. But I've noticed it's got it in lower case, and then it's got it in upper case the second time round. So I don't understand that. So we'll let it run and see what it does. Yeah, rewind tape. Yeah, there's a problem with it. Yeah, it's just not going to work. But I'll keep the case and I'll keep the tape. Because if I ever get, if I ever get another... I have tried the other side of it, by the way, folks. And the other side didn't work either. So there's something... I might try and clean the tape, that might help. But it might have dust or something on the tape. But what we'll do, we'll go back to the monitor and we'll go back to the main screen. I'll turn this off. Go back to the main screen and I can look at the chat. If we can find the fucking remote. There it is. Go back to the main screen. I can look at the remote. I can look at the chat then. There we go. Hey! Right, let's just turn that camera around. And you can all look at something fucking else. You look at my vintage hi-fi and across my bench. And you can enjoy the view for a minute. Let's see what we've got here. 11 people watching. Yeah. Yeah, hi, Harvey. Hi, Mark. Well, you know, yeah, you know. I mean, RF was acceptable when all we had was RF, but I think for these old computers, given that there's fuck all on RF and there's not really a lot of interference anymore, I think they work okay. You know. Yeah, I was in a lot of pain this afternoon with me frigging hip. Trying to put the bloody gas on me meter. Yeah. I know you were saying the other day, Harvey, you know, it's shit really, isn't it? Yeah, arcanoids. Yeah, it sounds like something like something you put cream on there, we know. Hemorrhoids. Hello, Washboard, how are you? Hello, Aaron. What's disgusting? Have I missed something? Just doing supper? What's disgusting about Harvey doing his supper? Yeah, I was in my teens when they came. I was about 14. Well, 14, 15 when these electrons came out. Right. I've never had Channel 4 come out of my spectrum. But yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it's bad news, really. You want to fight them, Harvey. You really do, mate. You're still looking at my Stereo 70? Right. Yeah, I'm going to do a video. Did I do a video of it playing the Philly Shave Twist? Did I put a video up of it playing the Philly Shave Twist? Can anyone tell me whether I did or not? I don't think I did I? Because I had a record player on it yesterday. If I did do a video, I might have deleted the fucker by mistake. So I'll do another video of it playing the Philly Shave Twist. It sounds all right, that steady old 70. That's going in my front room. It's there on the bench, as you can see. It's going in my front room. I might not use the leak tuner, although it is a good tuner, just in case one day I might have fancy listening to something on AM. I've got a Panasonic tuner, which is in keeping. I might use that. But we'll see. Yeah, we're not just going to sit here discussing that. I know I do feel sorry for you, Harvey, but we're not just going to fucking sit here discussing your predicament, are we? If we are, I'm pissing off, to be honest, because, you know, yeah, I do feel sorry for you. I'm not being horrible, but, you know, we're supposed to be talking about electronics, you know. You know, and is it right for you to discuss your personal business on here? I know I don't discuss mine on here. I don't want people knowing what I get up to. You know, but yeah, I do feel sorry for you. And I'm going to say one thing on it and one thing only. Appeal. That's all you can do, mate. You know, appeal, Harvey. That's all you can do. But a bit early for you subbing it, Harvey. Fuck, what time is it? It's not even 5 o'clock, not even 6 o'clock yet, is it? Oh, yeah, it is. 20 past six. Wow. Yeah, a bit early for your supper. You know, I mean, yeah, no, I wouldn't want to discuss my 1829. Yeah, just turned 1830 now. 6:30 now. No, I wouldn't want to discuss my personal business on here because at the end of it, we all come on and we all chat and we all have a laugh. We don't really fucking know each other, do we? You know, we don't. I mean, the only people who come on here, the only people who come on my channel, I've actually met, is Phil, John, Steve, and Jay. I don't know any of the rest of them. No, I've never had a wrist PC, Harvey. Sorry, Aaron. I've never had a wrist PC. I've had, I know someone who did years ago, but I never used it. And they never used it because they didn't know how, didn't have a clue. But the only Acorn machines I've actually used is the micro. I've used a couple of different models of the micro, and obviously that Acorn Electron, I've used that. But I was more, to be honest, when I was younger, I was more for Commodore because, you know, Commodore was in touch with the public, wasn't it? I mean, Commodore knew what people wanted, although people think Sinclair thought that. But Commodore really did because, you know, I think their Commodore 64 was the best, turned out to be the best-selling machine of all them so-called micros. I had a VIC 20. And I had a Commodore 64 and a Plus 4, and I think I can't remember rightly, but I think I did. I had a 16 as well, very, very briefly. The 16 and the Plus 4 were very closely related. But, yeah, I was a Commodore person. I didn't like the Spectrum because it was shit. I didn't want an Amstrad CPC 464 because I thought they were shit, but I realised actually that they're actually not that bad. They were actually quite a good machine. But the BBC Micro, yeah, that was good. I didn't get one until later on in life. And the problem with the BBC was the availability of games, because it was an education, it was designed for education use, so games weren't a priority, and pretty much any games that were released were actually educational anyway, most of them were. I mean, Acorn's idea of a games machine was the Electron. And yet, yeah, it was their idea of a games machine, yet they didn't put a joystick port on. But I do like all the old machines. I mean, the old machines. The old machines were. I can't say the computers were designed to last, but they were certainly more robust than what modern ones are. I mean, I think so. Well, that being said, yeah, I was more into Commodore. I didn't touch much, pretty much of anything else. I certainly didn't touch a Speccy. A friend of mine brought one round one night. We were gonna have a few beers. This was back in 1987. He says, "I'll bring me Spectrum round and we'll have a few cans." I said, "Yeah, okay then." So he brought it round. Started loading up Commando. He got to the picture of the Commando. It looked like a G.I. Joe running into battle, and the screen, and it froze. He unplugged it and it came back on with that same picture stuck in the memory. Obviously something had gone wrong, and that was the end of that. So we just end up having a beer. We never end up playing Commando. Which suited me really, but the Spectrums were rubbish. Bad, 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 bad. If Sinclair knew one thing, it was how to make crap. Yeah, I know it was, but the lad who brought it around in 87. But yeah, he brought it around in 87, so he'd had it a few years, obviously. It was on a cassette, as all the Spectrum games were, up until they were taken over by Amstrad, and the disk drive was added. But I have actually owned a CPC 464, but not back in the day when you could just walk into a shop and buy games for them. They were an ideal solution. I mean, anything by Amstrad, although everybody slags them off, anything by Amstrad, it's simplified, isn't it? I mean, it's there. You take it out of the box, plonk it down, and you can switch it on. There's none of this fucking about. There's no messing about with it. You just plug it in. And it had its first sprinkling of games as well. The 464. I mean, I never had one back in the day. I had a mate who did, and he bought one, but he went for the option without the monitor. He went and had the RF unit, and but yeah, if I was going to have one, I'd have gone for the colour monitor. I'd have paid the extra and gone for the colour monitor. Amstrad, they were, basically they were innovators. I mean, they gave you more than anybody else and didn't charge you more for it. Someone's just come up my path. They gave you more. You got more for your money and didn't pay more for it, which wasn't bad. Despite what people say, I'll tell you what. There's a lot of that hi-fi still knocking about, even though Alan Sugar himself said it were crap. It couldn't have been that bad. There's still a lot of them about. I mean, I've got three of them in here. Hello, 60s sounds on 33, 45 and 78. I'm not bad tonight, mate. I'm not bad. I'm not bad. I'm not bad. I'm just looking at... what's that? Scraps! Shut up! Shut up! You know, I mean, Alan Sugar's philosophy was simple: stack them, you know, pile them high and sell them cheap. You know, that was his philosophy, and it worked. I mean, you show me anyone in the '80s that didn't have a fucking Amstrad Stereo, an Amstrad stack system. Every fucker had them. He sold fucking millions of the damn things, you know, and oh, nice one. I'll keep an eye out for it. What did you not know? What, were you not born or too young? Or did you just not fancy one, Aaron? Yeah, well, that was it, you see. That was the philosophy, stack of mine, sell them cheap. I mean, but when you look at it, like I said before, as well as that, like I've said before, you know, a lot of them Amstrads, they had a lot of choice parts in them. They had a lot of branded parts in them. You know, and they were obviously designed to last. I've got, like I say, I've got three of them here. Two of them are in cabinets, one of them the cabinet's missing. That was how I got it. But the chassis actually does work perfectly. And it's still got the remote. That's right, they did. They did satellite receivers. They were very popular. They did the SRX-200 and the SRX-400. The 200 had, I think it was 16 channels. And I think the 400 had 20 channels, if I remember rightly. I can't remember offhand. But I know there was a difference. And the 400 also had the video crypt. The Thompson video clip decoder built in as well, where the 200 didn't. Yeah, I remember them. Remember it all very well. I remember it all. I think my internet connection just dropped out. I think it's come back on again. Getting fed up with that happening. You know, Well, Amstrad now belongs to B Sky B. Alan Sugar no longer owns it. He sold it to B Sky B. And all they make now is satellite boxes. High Street with Amstrad branded on it, because they only make B Sky B boxes. That's all it produces. Yeah, you enjoy your supper, Harvey. What, have you got anything nice? Yeah. Yeah, there's not... yeah, there's, you know, I mean... Yeah, I think my thing, there we go. Either the connection disappeared or it was buffering, doing something. Anyway, never mind. I knew a guy years ago, he's not with us anymore, and he said, I would never have anything to do with Amstrad. What he did, he got a pair of speaker boxes, I can't remember what they were, but they used to contain expensive speakers, and what he did, because there was no speakers in them, he bought a set of Amstrad speakers and put out and took them out of the boxes. You know, how about that one? I won't have anything Amstrad, he said. Yeah, he bought the speakers just to nick the speakers out of the boxes. Yeah. But, you know, I think everybody, most people have had one of them fucking Amstrad Hi-Fis. I've had about four of the bastards. Back in the days, I even bought new, the TS-35, that I bought that new, and and I don't know where it went after that. My dad sold it to one of his mates. Because they got, at the end of the day, I mean, I didn't think they were that bad. I mean, you know, people on here can say what they want. I mean, and if someone's never owned one, they shouldn't have an opinion. I think Alan Sugar could have spent a bit more money on the record deck. Yeah, I've got one, but they did. They gave you things. I mean, when I bought my TS-35 Mark IV, it was 199 quid. And it had a double tape deck on it. It had. It had everything that TS-33's got there. The only difference was it had a double tape deck, but that was exactly the same thing. And it was great because I could borrow tapes off my friends and I could run their tapes off. I didn't have to buy cassettes. Brilliant. Yeah, it's crap, isn't it? Yeah, I'm getting a lot of it here too. I'm fucking off in a minute. I'm going in a minute because it's doing my head in. I'll be perfectly honest. Doing my head in this buffer in. I'm getting the AMI screen fucking. Oh, BSB square reel. I'll tell you where there is one of them. Then BSB square reels, as well, if you go in Stockport at the side of Debenhams and Mersey Way at the side of Debenhams and look up, there's one up there. There's one up there on their roof. On the right at the top of the wall, there's one up there. A square reel. It's been there for fucking years. I mean, that was BSB, wasn't it? B Sky B, and it was taken over by Sky. It was slowly shut down and got rid of. They only bought it so they could get rid of it. That was like Samuel Colt of the Colt Firearm Manufacturing Company. He'd buy gun patents. He'd buy patents for guns, and the only reason why he did it was to keep them off the market. He had no intentions of actually manufacturing them. He just didn't want them on the market. Yeah, but I remember the B Sky Bs, the BSBs. I remember BSB boxes. And the square reel dish. Yeah, I thought they were neat, them square reels. They should have stuck with that. Because they don't look as bad as that. I mean, let's face it. Them satellite dishes, they're ugly looking things, aren't they? Especially the early ones that had Amstrad Fidelity sprayed on the front, silk screened on the front of them. They were white with Amstrad Fidelity all over them. They were fucking horrible. And then they started doing the ones with holes in them to try and stop the fucking, because they thought it was the rain that was causing the problem. Because it still did it even with the holes in it. But you know, it's only Sky Dishes that do that. It was only fucking Sky Boxes that did that. The fucking Freesat Boxes don't. You wouldn't get that now. The only time you get that is if your dish is out of alignment, whether it's locked up or... Yeah, well, that's fucking... Yeah. There we go. We're caught up again. But, yes, that lot there, we're buffering again. If you're having trouble hearing me, let me know. Then tell me and I'll just go, because there's no point me sat here trying to speak or whatever if I'm cutting out and everything, because I don't know that, because I can't hear myself. So... Ever had a Fidelity record player? I have, yes. In fact, actually, I've got one down here. A little Fidelity mini player. So, yes, I will own up to that. Yes, I have had a Fidelity record player. Indeed, I've actually got one. I don't actually have a problem with Fidelity. The only thing about Fidelity was the early stuff, the Texas Instruments chips. What used to cause the problem was the power supplies in them early units. When you switched them off, they used to oscillate, and it was the oscillations that burnt the. Because the power supply used to oscillate, which for the fur coat, no knickers. It's that series of videos. And I got it from Jay for spares, and then I decided to buy two of those cheap amplifier kits from China, and I think they worked out a couple of quid each. And I built two of them up, and I put them in it. And it worked absolutely beautifully. It was certainly better than what it was when capable of 4 watts per channel, which is a total of 8 watts. Both channels driven at 15 ohms in Buxton. And when it left here, it could do 20 watts into whatever fucking speaker you wanted to plug into it. A bit less with 8, and I don't think you could use 15s. 15s are hard to come across anyway. Odd is the 45 on the Pi label. That's Downtown by Purdue Town. Yeah, I don't mind. I wasn't a lover of Fidelity Hi-Fi systems, and that thing they brought out with the telly in it. I know someone who had one years ago, and he asked me what I thought, and I didn't tell him. I just said, you wouldn't respect my opinion. So I never told him. But to be honest, I thought they were crap. I've had a lot of Fidelity stuff. In fact, my first record player that I actually got bought for me by my parents was for Christmas in 1979, and it was a Fidelity UA9. And You know, yeah, brilliant. You know, I thought it was great. At the time, I had my own record player. I could play my records. Didn't have to sit in the same room as everybody else. I could sit up in my bedroom. It was great. I felt liberated, and it was liberating, sort of. You know, it meant that I didn't have to wait for my mum and dad to be out, because my mum and dad, they weren't into pop music. They didn't like pop music. My dad certainly couldn't stand pop music. Although he did listen to Piccadilly Radio, but he didn't like pop music. He weren't really, you know, his idea of pop music was Mario Lanza, popular about 50 fucking years ago, back then even. But, you know, my mum never really, doesn't really have a musical taste. And I developed my musical taste from my cousin, from our Robert, because he was into all the top stuff at the time. You know, so I developed my musical taste mainly from him. And I didn't develop it from my cousin Veronica, because she only listened to girly music, or fucking David Essex, or fucking the Osmonds. You know, woofters. But, yeah. But yeah, I like to think I've got a pretty wide. I like to think I've got a pretty wide variety, a pretty wide taste. Got a pretty broad taste when it comes to it, because I like stuff all the way from the 50s, with the exception of George Formby being the 40s and the 30s. But mainly when it comes to popular music, I like stuff from the 50s all the way up to about the late 80s. I don't like the 90s. The noughties are best left where it is. But there we go. You know, that's you know, I like to think my taste in music is very good, very broad, and yeah. Mildred was saying he might have another Philly Shave Twist in his stuff. If he has, I'm gonna auction it on here. See how many people are prepared to bid for it. Start it off a penny and see where it rises, see where it goes up to. Let you all fight for it. He mentioned it the other day. He says, I'm sure I've got another one. I said, well, if you have, let us have it. If I get it, I'm going to auction it on here. You know, because I know a load of you want it. But, yeah. It should be some fun. Yeah, 10 people watching, 10 like and 1 dislike. Who's the one who dislikes? Why don't you own up? Who's the one who doesn't like it? You probably don't like it. You probably sat there fucking watching it. I couldn't watch something I didn't like. Oh, the chat's gone quiet. Have we stagnated somewhere? I'll tell you what I have got coming up. I've got a real treat for you coming up soon. I'm gonna wanna clear this fucking stuff off the bench, which will probably be tomorrow. Because I can't be arsed fucking doing it now. What I'm thinking of doing, I'm gonna change the tone arm on a Bang & Olufsen record player. I'm not sure how I'm going to do it yet, but it is going to happen, because I'm not paying 300 quid for a fucking cartridge. Fucking 300 quid for a fucking cartridge. Cheeky bastards. Yeah, you know, I was collecting them. I was collecting them when... people were getting CD players. We don't want these. Do you want these? You know, one of my cousins, or one of my, is it second cousin? Yeah, one of my second cousins, Arvon's girl, one of Arvon's girls brought me a big box of the fuckers one day. Yeah, do you want these? Do you want these, our kid? I says, oh, no problem. Big box of records, all sorts in them. I don't think they were hers. Well, they were hers to give away, but I don't think they were what she collected. I think she used to mess about with car boot sales or something like that. And she just had them left over, so she thought I might want them, so she brought them to me. And so I ended up with them. I never say no to records, even now. I always collect records because, well, when I snuff it, my daughter can have a good car boot sale, can't she? You know, she can chuck all the shite on a car boot sale and get rid of it. I mean, some of it's worth money, some of it isn't. There's records on there that are probably worth a few quid. There's records on there that are probably worth fuck all. I'll tell you what I did do once, and this is true. I did a record fair once. It was years and years ago. A long time ago, back about 2008 or something. I was invited to do a record fair. And I'd bought a load of records for a fiver. And at the same time, I also gave the guy a fiver for a 4H, a Garrard 4H. This is before eBay. I don't get fuck all now. Anyway. Well, eBay was about, but he weren't doing that. He weren't putting his stuff on there. He was getting stuff off the tip. Anyway, he got these fucking records and he brought them round. I can't remember what was on all of them. Anyway, so I went through them, and what I've got, what I kept is what's on me, some of what I kept on my bookcase there. And what I didn't keep, I put in crates. And I went through my own collection and decided what I didn't want, what I'm never going to play, and they all went in a crate. And I had two or three crates of records, maybe a few more. And I took them down to this place. And there was this guy next to me, a record dealer next to me, and he looked like he'd just got off a Harley Davidson. He had a big beard, a fucking cut-down Wrangler jacket, patches all over it. Looked like a right greaser, but knew his stuff. And he says to me, he says, do you mind if I have a shufty through him? I says, no, go ahead, mate. And he picked out about four or five LPs, pulled them out of the sleeves. I can't remember what they were. Pulled them out of the sleeves. It was a long time ago. I can't remember what they were. He pulled them out of his sleeve. He pulled them out of the sleeves, and he examined them. And I mean, he examined them meticulously. He spent a couple of minutes looking at the side of each side of every one of them, and then he put 400 quid in my hand. He said, will that cover him? I just fucking nearly fell to the floor. I said, yeah. Good investment on me fiver. I said, yeah. Don't know what, I can't remember what they were. But he bought them. And I says to him, I says, how come they're worth so much? He says, because I know what I'm buying. He says, And he explained a few things. I can't remember it all now. But he explained a few things to me. He says, the things to look for, he says, is one of the things. He said, one of the things to look for, and the most important things to look for, he says, is the stamper number. He said, because every record has a stamper number stamped after the run-out groove, just after the lock groove. He said, you find it just on the outside, on the inside of the lock groove. He says, it's a run out. He said, what it is, it says it's a stamper number. And that tells you whether the stamper is a first, whether the record is a first edition pressing, or whether it's second edition. He says, because the stamper, because the stampers only can, the stampers can only print so many, can only stamp so many, and then they have to change it and put a new stamper in, well, a new set of stampers, because they do an A and a B side. He said, but they can only do make so many with them, and then they have to commission a new stamper. He says, and the stamper will have another number on it. He says, and that's what you look at. He says, and that series of numbers tells you whether it's a first edition or not. He said, they can put what they want on the sleeve. So they can put what they want on the label, he says, but it's what's on the... He says, it's the number that's on the disc that's actually stamped in. And just about every record has one. You know, He said, you decode it from that, you decode it from that number, and it tells you what edition the record was. But, you know, that was what he was telling me. Yeah, apparently they all have them, including this one here, which is a cheap and nasty record. It's called Cruising 20 Classic Tracks. And this will have one on it. This is a Pickwick. Oh, no, it's not. Same shit. Yeah, it is. Pickwick Star Tracks. I wouldn't imagine the stampers for that would have been much cop. I bet this hadn't even got... Yeah, this has got a number on it as well. And the numbers are handwritten. You can hardly read that one. And it's upside down. And the numbers are usually handwritten. Well, they are handwritten because the person who signs it, that one's got some fucker's initials in it. D.I.123. And then we've got a big long serial number there. And then we've got A, we've got J, which looks like an A, but the crossbar's missing. And it says tape one. It says tape one. Now let's have a look at the other side. Oh, sorry there, I just caught the phone. And that probably says tape one, which it does. So, you know, basically, it is AJ, it is JA, tape one, and then you've got your serial number, which is SHM 368 on the label, and it matches that, and it's, and B1, it probably stands for, and let's have a look at the other side. And that's A1. So that was probably that means it's the A side, and probably stamper one. So that's probably you know, I've never really got into decoding records, but I really should, because I've got some valuable ones. I've got some that fella never got because they weren't with me. And the reason why they weren't with me is because they're part of my own collection. Because I don't keep every record I buy. I might buy a job lot of records, and from that job lot, I'll sell some of them, and I'll keep some of them. I mean, I'm trying to think. I'll tell you what, I'm not going to do that because it won't fit in there. I'll put it on top of there for now. But yeah, that's... So basically, it has the label number on there. It has, on that particular one anyway, it has the label number. It has the stamper number. and somebody had autographed it, and they'd also put the number of the tape that it came from. That it was recorded from. Yeah. Yeah, Outrun. What was Outrun? I played a lot. Yeah, well, that's it, you see, you know, but I don't refuse records. If somebody offers me records, I take them. I want to give Mildred a quick ring. Want to see if he's anywhere near an Aldi tonight. If he is, I'll ask him to pick me up a few bits. If he's not, then I'll suffer. Where is he? Mildred, where are you? There you are.
Hello?
Hello, is Mildred there, Brenda?
Driving, Andy.
Right, is he anywhere near an Aldi tonight, do you know?
We've already been.
Have you already been? Oh, it's okay.
Yeah, we've been.
Oh, no worries.
All right, then.
Okay, I'll catch you later.
See you later.
Bye.
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 Yeah, never mind. I knew I should have rung him earlier. Never mind, what I wanted to keep until tomorrow. I only wanted a loaf. But, I only have it from Aldi. I don't want it from anywhere else because it's usually shit. And dear. But, oh, right. Yeah, I remember it now. Yeah, what I actually want, I mean, somebody must know, what I actually want is audio files that can be put onto tape, you know, recorded from the computer straight onto a tape and then put into a machine and played, put into a tape machine and then loaded up onto the... onto the Acorn. I know they do exist. It's where you get them from. Because it's no good downloading ROMs, because you can't put them on a cassette. It has to be done through an audio method. I'll have a word with Jay about that in a bit. I'll give Jay a ring. See if he knows anything about it. I mean, I could research it on Google, but I'm too lazy. I am, folks. I'm too lazy to mess about. Yeah, I've got a thing there. Oh, there's another guy who would know. Gadget UK, for Gadget UK. 4164. Yeah, he would know as well. There's a few people who would know, to be honest. But I don't know, so I need to find out. Right, so Yeah, I'm just looking at my comments from the other video. Yeah, so that Matsui is what would have been supplied with it. Yeah. Yeah, that's it. It's actually, for what it is, it's actually a good cassette player. Not bad. Yeah, don't remember playing Joe Blade. Rambo is hard as, yeah. Yeah, I can imagine. I've got a copy of Rambo here, but it's fucking, it's for the BBC. It's for the Commodore 64, which is a bit of a bummer. Because, if I want to play that, it means I've got a copy of Snooker as well. I've got a copy of Snooker, which is for the Commodore 64, which is a bit of a bummer. But then Commodore 64 games, I'm just gonna chuck them in Jay's pile. Because I won't use them. I don't want to buy a Commodore 64. I liked them back in the day, but I don't want to buy another one. Besides, have you seen the prices of them anyway? Back in the 90s and early 2000s, before this fucking eBay shite, you could get Commodore 64s for a couple of quid. I remember buying a Spectrum once. It was a cassette drive one. It was the 128 one with the built-in cassette recorder. I think I paid, how much did I pay for it? Fucking very little. I think it was a fiver. It was in a hold all full of games. Fucking hold all full of games with this fucking thing, and I gave a fiver for it. I wish I still had it. I'd put the bastard thing on eBay. Yeah, is everyone still here? Yeah, pretty much everyone in the list is generally here, aren't they? There's 11 people watching. There's 11 people watching. 10 people like it. One person dislikes it. The chat's been interesting anyway. Like I say, we've got a Bang & Olufsen coming up at some point. And we're gonna put that on the bench, and we're gonna try and change or do something with the tone arm so that I can put a P mount cartridge into it. I mean, the tone arm I'm going to use hasn't got a stylus in it, but it has got a cartridge. But it doesn't mean to say I have to use that cartridge. I can put any P-mount cartridge into that. It's a Technics tone arm. I think the Bang & Olufsen tone arm is a bit thinner than the one I'm going to use. But that's no problem. That's no problem because that suits my purpose anyway, being a bit thinner. Because it'll mean that if I can't swap the entire arm, I can swap the part that matters, which is the wand. Swap the wand, which is the metal bit in the middle, and graft it onto the Bang & Olufsen unit. £300 for a fucking cartridge, that's taking the piss. Cheeky bastards. I don't know where they get off charging that. I wonder if the people who decide they want that much, I wonder if they can sleep at night. Yeah, there was. Oh, it's Mick, isn't it? Yeah, there's some Commodore games in there, Mick. Yeah. About 10 of them, I think. Yeah, I think there was some Commodore. I think there was about 10 of them. There's a couple on the desk here. Some have got no tapes in them. Yeah, some of them were Commodore 64. Yeah, which doesn't matter because I can get rid of them. Because I don't fancy a Commodore 64. Blaze out, that's for the Commodore 64, stroke 128, which means it should work on both machines. I had a Commodore years ago. I remember when you could the price, but the price, the reason why I don't want one is the prices they want for them on eBay is ridiculous. I was looking at them a while back and they're just expensive. Right, I might be interested in that sorry, Mick. Yeah, I had Commodore machines when I was younger. I had a Commodore VIC-20 and a Commodore 64. The Commodore VIC-20, that was actually quite a good machine. It wasn't bad for what it was. I mean, it wasn't as good as the 64, but it wasn't as good as the 64, but it was certainly decent enough for getting the job done. Yeah, they are horrible to work on washboard. That's very, very true. But look on the brighter side. It ain't you that's going to be working on it. It's going to be me. But I don't know where they get off with charging £300 for a cartridge. I don't know how they can. But there are people in this world that can't sleep at night. There really are. I mean, there's people that can't sleep at night. I mean, let's face it, when Dick Turpin robbed people, at least he put a mask on. You know what I mean? He had the decency to put a fucking mask on. But, most of those Commodore games I put in the drawer. There's one on the floor there that's got no case. It fell out, fell onto the floor. I've not bent down for it yet. I think there's, there's a couple there on top of that speaker. They're Commodore, I think so. Anyway, let's have a quick look. Yeah. What have we got here? Time traveler. You need a light gun for that, I believe. But it don't make any difference because it's for the Commodore. Ghostbusters. C64. Yeah, Commodore. Yeah, time traveler. Commodore 64. Yeah. Stroke 128, so it'll work on both. Probably 128 version on one side and the 64 version on the other side. What else was there? Oops, no speakers falling over. Shit. Ah, get there back there, you bastard. There we go. Match day, Commodore 64's got no game in it. Ooh. Ferrari Formula One. I wouldn't mind playing that, but it's for the Commodore 64. And that's on two. That's either. Oh, that's a demo tape. Power pack. Yeah. It doesn't say what that's for. Doesn't say what that one's for. Just says 10th frame. Doesn't say, let's find out. What's this other one that dropped on the floor? Let's pick that up. Ferrari Formula One. That's either two tape or it's two copies of the same thing. Let's find out. Let's put this. Let's turn this Acorn back on. Let's have a look. I want to see what it is. Go back to my channel. There we go. Let's see what it is. Don't know, it could be something on that. I think it's for the C64, but yeah, there's some more in here. I chucked them in this drawer, I think. Can't get to them. The speakers are in the way. Oops. Let's put the speakers down here for a minute. There they all are. I should go through these because some of these are... I should go through these again because some of them are blank. I haven't found anything, so... Yeah, Commodore. Which is a shame, really. Because... CBM64, there's Rambo, joystick only, CBM64, or 128, yeah, if you want them Commodore 64 games, Mick, to play on your Commodore, let me know. That one's got a bit twisted. Predator. Commodore 64. CBM 64. I remember just about all these. The music system, that'll be for the CBM 64. Because it had a good sound chip in the Commodore 64. It had the SID chip. Snooker, I wanted to play that. Professional snooker simulator. Yeah, that looks interesting, that. But obviously I can't play it because it ain't for my machine. Shoot 'em up construction kit. CBM 64. Audio tape. That's audio tape. Yeah, Commodore 64. Yeah. If you want these tapes to play on your Commodore, Mick, let me know. That's a pop quiz. Commodore. Yeah, and that's 1985. Yeah. I'm just double checking because you never know, you know. I'll tell you what is remarkable, the fact that these games actually still play after all these years. I'm making sure there's no Electron games here by mistake. Pit stop two. I'm going to have to buy a Commodore 64. That's got no tape in it. Aliens. Yep, Commodore. Yeah, they're all Commodore, them ones. Everyone. And what's this one here? Music. Yep. But that one there is a Commodore one as well, because it doesn't read it. Because the Acorn doesn't read it. I'm going to see if it reads. I'll put all these back in here. And I know they're safe. We'll be all right in there. Where's that one I was just going to... Where's that blank one I came across? I better throw it in here, hadn't I? I must have done because it ain't there. Oh, what an idiot. Trying to find that now. Where's that fucking blank one? There was a blank one. I'm going to throw it in there, see what's on it. Fell down the back there, has it? No. Right. You know, I hate it when stuff like that happens. I put it down, I've lifted it up with the rest of them. Let's go through that lot. It was on here, under there, I just moved it. There it is. A Currys branded tape. And wings band on the run, a C60 full of music. Let's rewind it. Oh, hang on, let's put them in there. Yeah, Commodore 64. Yeah. Remember it well. I think it was the best selling motocross quattro power motocross sim. Yeah. AV sim, powerbolt sim, the case, so that's in that drawer. Put it in there. That's it. Let's see what we've got. Let's give it a couple of seconds. Because people used to put loads of stuff on tapes, I used to. It was surprising what people used to. I used to get tapes years ago. And it was surprising what people used to put on them. I mean, I got a load of Commodore tapes. They were VIC 20. And on a couple of them, the guy had been using his machine for doing his accounts and stuff. Just unplug that and see if it's got music coming out of it. Right, so we know that ain't gonna really read. Right. There we go. Let's turn that off. Let's go back to here. Go back to the chat, why not, eh? Yeah, so that's it. Yeah. So, ow, my bloody hip. Hello, Steve. Hello, Chris. Yeah, they sound different, don't they? I mean, you know, but the thing is, it says what it is on the. It says what it is. Yeah, I know, washboard. The yeah, you're welcome. You're welcome, mate. Yeah, there's a couple of buttons. It's got a couple of iffy keys, but I've ordered some. So I'll be doing a video on that probably next week. That's if they turn up next week. I'm hoping they do. The return key's a bit dodgy. There's number five. And the E key didn't work, the letter E didn't work, so I nicked one of the shift keys to sort that out with. So that'll be done. I'll do all that next week. But yeah, it's not bad for an old machine. I mean, a lot of them, the ULAs have died in them, but you know, obviously that one is still good. Yeah, you know, I mean, they take the piss, washboard, when it comes to chat, you know, they take the piss. I mean, I don't care what they say. No cartridge is worth 300 quid. I don't care what they say. And, you know, I'm not sure if you could replace the stylus in them being old cartridges or not. Some of them you could, but some of them you couldn't. I'm not sure if they're moving magnet or moving coil. But I think it's moving coil. I think it's moving magnet ones. I think it's moving magnet ones you have to send to be rebuilt. I think the moving coil ones—they're the ones that you can do, pull the stylus out of. Weird, but yeah. Yeah, they did. Yeah, they. Mind you, most things used to die in spectrums. Yeah, they were Agfa tapes, weren't they, Curries? Yeah. Yeah, you know, yeah. I have listened to a couple through the speaker, but that noise irritates me. But you know, on most of them it says what they are. You know, it's just as easy to just pop it into the machine, and if it doesn't come up within a couple of, it doesn't come up within a minute at least, 30 seconds even. If it doesn't come up within that amount of time, it ain't for that machine. You know, so. But yeah, I'm very pleased with my Acorn. Very. Very pleased with it, and I'm hoping to get a lot of hours use out of it. But yeah, you know, it's what can I say? I'm just looking to see. Well, I've not had a battery dead message yet, so yeah. Yeah, is that to have the stylus replaced, or is that one you can replace yourself, washboard? You know, I mean, I wouldn't buy a cartridge off eBay because I've seen them on there for like 40 quid, and I still wouldn't pay it because if it's one of the ones you have to have a stylus replaced, if it's the type you have to send off and have the stylus done. And you just, you may as well, you know, you may as well wipe your arse on the 40 quid and flush it down the lavatory, because that's what you've just done. You may as well burn it. You've just burnt 40 quid, you know, because you've got to pay 200 to have the stylus fitted. So is that with the stylus fitted by them, or is that for a stylus and you put it in yourself? What are we talking here? There's 200 quid's a lot of money for a stylus. If you bought a stylus for 200 quid, you wouldn't want to play a record on it, would you? You'd be scared to play a record on it. I mean, you really would. You know, you'd be frightened. You'd only have to drop it too heavy and it's gone. Yeah, sorry. I always get it mixed up. I get that mixed up. Me washboard moving coil and moving. Yeah. You know, it's, you know, I always get confused with moving magnet and moving coil. Yeah, of course it's moving coil, isn't it? Moving magnet, you replace yourself. Yeah, I get confused with it. I mean, I shouldn't, but I do. I get confused with it. I mean, they even have different bias settings as well for moving magnet and moving coil. Because I've got a preamp in my drawer, a pretty expensive one, phono preamp in my drawer, and it's you can actually select moving magnet or moving coil, and obviously they have different either sensitivity, different biases, or what? Yeah, they're somewhat different, but yeah, I wouldn't want to pay £200 for a stylus. You know, drop it on a record too hard, or play a record that's got a cracking and you've not seen it, gone on it. 200 quid down the swanny. No matter how much you try and console yourself, you'd never do it. I think if I spend that kind of money and then ruin the stylus, I'd never be able to recover from it. I just don't think I'd be able to. I just don't think I'd be able to pull myself back round again. Impedance, that's it, yeah. Not bias, impedance. Yes, it's, yeah, the impedances are different, aren't they? I mean, you know, but yeah. In fact, I'll show you that. I'll see if I can fish that out and show it to you. Where's it likely to be? It's an expensive thing, this. Because I don't buy crap. I'm not into buying crap. But it ain't in there. So if it ain't in there, it's got to be in here. And if it ain't in here, there it is. It needs a clean. It fucking sat around for years. I bought it, but I don't really use it. But at the time I bought it, I did. Because at the time I was running an amplifier. I didn't have a phono stage. So I bought that. And This is fairly expensive. It was, I say expensive, it was 60 odd quid, and I think that's dear. You can put 9 volts AC or DC up it, doesn't matter, you can put both. And it's made by Art Accessories, DJ Pre 2, phono preamplifier. Yeah, input capacitor. You've got 100 picofarad or 200 picofarad. Filter, you got low, cut and flat. No, it hasn't got for moving coil on it. I thought it had. And then you've got a gain there. Gain trim. So you can trim it. Power indicator and a power LED. This is got a ground on it there. This is kept in case it's ever needed. The input capacitor is for the cartridge loading. Yeah. Yeah. Let me just give you a quick look at this. I don't know if you can see that. That's what it is, and that was, it's all aluminium, that, it's not plastic. It was expensive. Well, I think 60 quid's expensive. Put it that way. It was nearly, in fact, it was nearer 70 than what it was 60. About fucking 65 quid or something fucking that. But that is an expensive, I don't know where the power supply has gone for it, but you can use any. You know, I didn't mind paying for that, because, you know, it's, although it's not been used for a long time, it is something that will get used, should I want to. You know, it's, I might even put it in an Allen Sugar shitter and put a magnetic cartridge in the tone arm. How about that one? Yes. Well, a Shure V5 Mark. What's fucking V1? Why can't you put it on in proper numbers instead of Roman numerals? I hate Roman numerals. I don't understand the damn things. I'm English, I'm not a Roman. The fucking Mark 1V, whatever that happens to be. Mark 4. Right, cheers, Harvey, that helps that, because I'm going to get you a price on that now. It won't be dear, I don't think. Sure, stylus is not really that dear. Certain ones are not, anyway, just certain ones that are. But you probably find those as a range of styluses you put in that. It doesn't have to be a short one. Let me just go back to. Yeah. Yeah, I know. I know it is Harvey. So I don't know why they do that. If anybody knows, if anybody knows why they do that, then yeah, that would be interesting. Why are they? Is it because Roman numerals is some sort of international numbering system? Is that the reason why they do it? I don't know. Is it because the rest of the world have trouble understanding 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 5? I don't know. Right, let's see what we get. Ooh, lovely. Yeah. Ooh. Yeah. I'll tell you what. Show V15 Mark two. The Mark 3 there. Can't see the Mark 4. Let's keep going down. There's a Mark 4. Oh, Harvey. Oh, take that cartridge out and put it in the bin. Put an Audio Technica in there. Oh. Well, there's one. Almost gone. I'm not surprised at that price. That's a Mark II, but the Mark II, they all look the fucking same, to be honest. They're different stylus for sure. V15, V15-2, V15-2E, V15. Yeah, they're all the same, and that'll fit. Well, there's one. Yeah, they'll all fit then. They're all the same fucking stylus as one there. A replacement turntable stylus is probably not sure. Well, it will fit that cartridge. For dual DN. Yeah, V. Yeah, that'll fit. Yeah, that. Let's have a look. Yeah. Doesn't really give you a good look at it, really. But I would imagine that would fit. Yeah, because they have a stylus card on them and all, don't they? Yeah. Yeah. VN for, oh, it's for a VN35. Or a DN30, or a short, or a dual equivalent. So, yeah. Yeah, I would be thinking. So, that's fucking dear, that really. I mean, there's one there. It's the M44, the M55, and the V15. That's 24 quid. So you can get them, Harvey, as long as you ain't too fucking fussy. You can get them, yeah, these ones here, they just don't have a stylus card on them. To all intents and purposes, sure, styluses are pretty much all the fucking same anyway. Most of them. There's only a few different ones that have got bigger fucking cases. Got bigger cases on all the stylus fucking lever in place. But, you know, all the stylus bar in place and the bit that goes into the cartridge. Other than that, most of them are the fucking same anyway. There's one there, £46. I think I'd rather go. It's basically, it's the same as what, it's basically the same thing I've just looked at for £24, except it's got a stylus card on it. But that would, that £24 one will fit your cartridge, Harvey. So, you know, there you go. You know, £24's not too bad, it will fit. That'll fit in that cartridge. £24's not too bad. You know, but yeah, that was on eBay. I mean, I've actually had some. They're not all that bad, washboard. I've actually had some. I don't use a Shaw cartridge anymore. I use an Autofen. I forget what model it is, but I use an Autofen in my Zero. But I have got cartridges. I have got a music centre with a Shaw in it. And I've bought some of these third party Shaw cartridges. It depends where you buy them. You know, depends where you buy them. Depends where you buy and how much you pay. The more you pay, is general rule of thumb, the better you get. You pay for what you get, I suppose. You know, if you pay a tenner, then you're going to get a rusty nail in a cartridge shell. If you in a stylus shell rather, if you you know, I think anywhere upwards of like £25 and up, and you're gonna get a decent stylus. I generally only shop in a couple of places for styluses. I've had no trouble with them. There's the stylus lady on eBay. I buy from her. I've had no problems with anything yet. And there's another one. I think it's called Lords, and I've had from him as well. I've had from them, and I've had no trouble. Musonic, I tend to avoid because they're fucking expensive. I don't go anywhere near Musonic. I avoid them. But you know what I would do. Well, to be honest, it's up to you, Harvey. I don't know. £24's not a bad price. You know, for a stylus, and. You know, if you're not happy with it, you can send them back. There's a guy who I can't remember who he is, but I bought a stylus off a guy. It was a GP91 from me Clark and Smith. And I ordered it with a 78 RPM tip. And he sent me one without a 78 RPM tip. So he had his phone number in the paperwork that came with it. In the invoice, he had his phone number, so I phoned him up. And I explained that it wasn't good enough. Because most of what I play on my Clark and Smith is my George Formby records. That's what I very rarely use. The LP side. That's why I wanted the 78. So, anyway, he said, well, that's not a problem. You know, he said, send it back, I'll send you a 78 one out. So I said, right. So I sent it back. He paid for the postage. I sent it, well, actually, yeah, he did pay for the postage. And he sent me another one out, postage free. So, you know, people where you can do that and send them back. I never buy off anybody who says they won't accept returns, because by law they have to accept returns. No matter what they put, they have to, because that's the law in the UK. Yeah, Stanton are, to touch up on that, my disco console at the back of the room there, that's got Stanton's in it. It's got Stanton 500s in it. And the Stanton's are mainly a DJ cartridge. And the Autophone, yeah, I use Autophone in my Garage Zero. Because I just think they're better than Shaw. I think they've got a nicer sound. The sound is more rich, I think. But it's all down to personal preference. It's down to what you want and what you like. Well, I always find, when it comes to cartridges. I was told by a guy years ago, I was buying some capacitors for a jukebox that I was doing. It was the Roami Diplomat I used to own. I was working on the amplifier in that, and I ordered some capacitors, and the guy was telling me about the cartridges. And he was saying, I think, if I get this the wrong way around, I apologise, but the conversation was a long time ago. But basically, he said that the inside channels are quieter, the inside windings are quieter than the outside windings of the cartridge. And they leave it to the amplifier manufacturer to sort that out in the balancing of the amplifier, you know, so that's how it's done. That's what I was told anyway. But yeah. Yeah, the Autophones are nice. I mean, I get the I've got a friend in London. He deals in jukeboxes, and I get my stylus. When I need a new Autophone stylus, I get it from him. I think he only charges about, he does them at 17 quid. I think he normally does them for me for a bit cheaper, because we're friends, but, he normally does them for about, I don't know, about 10, between 10 and 15 quid or something like that, if I want them. But, and because they're made for jukeboxes, they're a bit harder. So they can stand a bit more, they can stand the rigors of time. You don't have to change them as often because they are harder, and they slip right in to the Autophone cartridge. They're perfect, and they sound okay. I've never had one damage a record, but I change the stylus regular. The one that's in it is a couple of years old, but it's only played about 3 or 4 records. Because I don't sit in there that often. But the Zero's up for a service at some point. Because I know it needs a service, because it sits around doing fuck all most of the time. But yeah, I like the fans. They do make a nice sound, that's absolutely true. They make a nice sound. Stanton are good if you're using it in a DJ environment, because that's what they're really made for. Another good cartridge, and nobody's mentioned it, and I'm surprised that nobody's mentioned it, is the Pickering. The Pickering cartridges, they're not bad. They basically look like a Stanton 500. They look like a Stanton 500, but they have a different stylus. They're very similar. They have a different type of stylus. But, yeah. The Pickering, that's a good cartridge. I've had a few of them. Yeah, Stanton's an American brand as well. I mean, their styluses, they have the American flag plastered all over them. The cases do. The cartridges do and all. But the nice thing about the Stantons is you can buy, look, there's third-party ones everywhere. And if all you're doing is stood in a pub spinning records with them, they're good enough. You know, but cartridges are like food, aren't they? I mean, they're like food. It's all down to personal taste. At the end of the day, it's all down to personal taste. It's down to what you want. You know, what you like. You know, I always find that Shaws are nice cartridges, but I always find they're a bit lower on one channel than they are on the other. And I find autophones don't suffer from that. Oh, Shaws do make excellent mics, Harvey. You know, I had I had a Shaw, I think it was SM50 microphone. I think it was an SM50 or something like that. I've had a few Shaw mics. All the professionals use Shaw mics. You know, fucking, they're just decent mics. Another good microphone is the Audio Technica. They make an after, or they used to. You know, I bought an Audio Technica mic when I first started doing disco. I bought it from a music shop in Hill Green, not far from me. A little small music shop. I bought it from there. I think it was 30 quid. And I had that microphone for over 10 years. And during my ownership of it, all I ever replaced was the on-off switch. That was all I ever replaced. It had the original lead that was supplied, the original plugs on the lead that were supplied. Never changed them. Had the original microphone element in there, never changed it. All I ever changed was the switch, because the switch jammed. It went very stiff and just worked well. It just wore out, really. So all I did, I took it apart, put a new switch in it. Yeah, when I sold it, with a karaoke player. I let it go with a karaoke player. It had no paint on it or anything, this mic. It was completely worn. Because it had had a lot of use in a lot of years, and it was a damn good microphone. But I've had Shaw mics, and Shaw mics are good mics. I'm just looking at the chat here. Yeah, you know, the last show I had, it was all original. The one I was just talking about was an Audio Technica one. But they're just as good, them Audio Technicas, the old ones anyway. They're not bad mics. And they're actually okay. You know, a lot of that stuff's okay. But yeah, I do like Shure mics. Yeah, I do think Shure mics are good. All the professionals use them. You know, but when you're turning them off every couple of minutes, turn them on and off, the switches do wear on them, unfortunately. What I used to do, this console I've got here. I used to switch the mic, to save the mic switch, I used to switch it off. This has got a switch on it here, you can turn it on and off. So I used to do that. But not all consoles give you the luxury of that, and some of the early ones I had didn't. But it is nice to be able to turn your mic off at the console. That way you save. Because it doesn't take much to just bring your hand down with your mic in it, put your mic on the mic holder, and at the same time just flick the switch. And yeah, I'm just eating a couple of biscuits while I'm chewing the fat with you lads. I'm gonna get off in a minute, actually. How long have we been on? 2 hours. Wow. Surprising how much shit a man can talk about in 2 hours, isn't it? You know, but yeah, I'm gonna do one. And I'm gonna do one partly because I need a piss. I ain't letting you lot listen to me have a piss. Anyway, I'm gonna shoot off, folks. And keep an eye out for the Bang & Olufsen coming on. Well, that'll probably be in the next couple of days. I'm gonna try and change the tone arm. If I muck it up, I'm not bothered. I might even do it live. If I muck it up, I ain't bothered. Right, well, you get your head down, Harvey, and like I say, don't discuss your personal business, because we don't know each other on here, and my opinion is appeal. But yeah, but only tell people on here what you really want them to know. I mean, I don't even neighbour. I don't, honestly. What B&O is it? It's a B&O Centre 2000 and 2200. It's either a 2200 or a 2000. It's really not actually a B&O at all. It's some Japanese piece of shit. With B&O stamped on it and probably a lump of concrete in the bottom to give it weight. Yeah, you all take care as well. It's nice that you could join me tonight. And we've had a bit of fun with the Electron. You know, Mick, if you're watching, if you want those Commodore cassettes to play on your Commodore, you're welcome to them, because I can't use them. Certainly, I don't mind that. Yeah, but, you know, but there we go. Yeah. What else is there? There's nothing else, really. I'm out of here. I'm going before I turn my trousers into a portable sewage plant. You all take it easy and stay safe. And, you know, wear a mask when you go out. See, if you wear a mask when you go out, nobody will realise how fucking ugly you are. See you later, alligators, in a bit. Right, I'm out of here. Because I really do need to go and have a slash. Bye for now, folks.